Hi, welcome to the Adulting 101 Cooking Edition series. We'll need 2 cups of flour, pizza sauce to your taste, some cheese to your taste as well, 1 cup of warm water, 1 tablespoon of olive oil, 1 tablespoon of sugar, 1 tablespoon of yeast, and 1 teaspoon of salt. Our first step is to preheat the oven to 425 degrees. And mix the warm water with the tablespoon of sugar and the tablespoon of yeast. Make sure you mix it properly so you get one consistent solution. Let it sit for 5 minutes until it looks like this, and add the tablespoon of olive oil and make sure you mix it vigorously, like really, really well. Just like this. We will now add our 2 cups of flour to the solution. Make sure you add the teaspoon of salt before you start mixing. And now, since we have already added it, we start beating it. Make sure you beat it properly and consistently so you get one consistent solution until it starts looking like a doughy thing. If you need to, you can add 1/2 cup of flour so you get a more consistent solution. Now, after you feel it's consistent enough, that's when you start using your hands. So you're gonna beat it, smash it, whack it, and get it into a nice, nice consistency. Just like this. So it should look like a bowl like this. You can let it rest for up to 30 minutes, or you can just put it in the pan already. For preparing the pan, let's spray some oil or butter alongside with a little bit of flour all over it. Make sure you shake it really well. That's for us to avoid the dough sticking to the pan. Now, we're gonna prepare our table so we can start spreading our dough. Okay, you see it's bigger? It'll get smaller shortly. It's the air. Okay, so you start beating it with your hands. So you get rid of all those bubbles that were formed while you wait for it. Now put it on the surface and start smashing it with your hands. Just like this. Flip it. You can do the shape that you want. On my case, I use a circle shape, so I try to make it very similar. Almost a perfect size, but no. Okay. So once it's in the pan, I want to spread it a little bit. You can spread it or you can leave it as it is. Grab a fork and start poking it. Do it multiple times. This is to avoid getting a lot of bubbles in your dough. Let's pre-bake it for 5 minutes. And once it's out, you can smash it with your hand a little bit because it'll get inflated. That's normal. And we'll start spreading our olive oil all over the pizza surface. Make sure you spread it nice and evenly so you get that olive oil taste all over the dough. I promise you, it'll be very, very much worth it. Okay, so moving on, we will now add our sauce. Make sure you also spread it evenly. It is up to you how much sauce you want to use, but in my case, the more, the merrier. So it is entirely up to you. Now, for my favorite part, we're gonna start adding our cheese to the surface. Make sure you spread it nice and evenly. It is up to you how much cheese you want to use. On my case, I like it very cheesy, even though that's cheesy. Haha. Okay, so. And moving on, it is now time for us to start putting on our toppings. You can use as many toppings as you want. You can use vegetables, you can use meats. It is up to you how you want your pizza. In my case, I do 1/2 and 1/2 because this pizza is big enough for 2. So, I share it with one of my roommates. So, it'll be a great opportunity for you if you want to impress a special someone. Once we finish adding our toppings to our pizza, we're gonna bake it for 15 minutes in the oven. And when it's out, you can add those Italian spices that you like or some Parmesan cheese. Make sure you cut it on parts. And the last part is for you too. Enjoy. Doesn't this look amazing? Oh yeah.